We're used to seeing Nick Brax in his underdacks. The former underwear model has been strutting his stuff on the catwalk for close to a decade, shooting to fame as a teenager and growing up in the public eye. But behind his million-dollar smile, Nick was fighting a private battle.
Suffering from anxiety and depression, the 32-year-old fought to maintain a healthy mindset while juggling a career on screens and magazine covers across the country. Now the actor and advocate is sharing his personal story to help Aussies tackle the stigma around mental health. And Nick Brax joins us live from Melbourne this afternoon. Hello, Nick. Now, this really seems, I guess, a world away from how we're used to seeing you as a model. So tell us about your own struggle with mental health.
Yeah, I mean, I had a really tough time when I finished up at high school. And I guess growing up, I had issues with anxiety and a whole range of things I wasn't aware about, and it elevated and became debilitating. I eventually worked through it, got sort of asked to speak. I was in the media at the time and had an opportunity to speak out about it. And since then, I've done a whole range of other things, but I have just kept working in this area, and it's really organically turned into a career. It's something that is the closest thing to my heart, that I just want to live my life trying to do, you know, make a small change in this area, because it's something that affects so many people.
Yeah.
Nick, you've always been in the public eye, not only as a model and an actor, but you're the son of the former Victorian Premier Steve Brax. Was there pressure on you, do you think, from a young age?
I think there was only pressure on me from myself. I mean, and this is a lot of the messaging that I really try and pass on through the work that I do. I was putting this immense pressure on myself because I felt like I was having an identity crisis. I felt like I've got to prove that I'm not the son of this person. I'm Nick Brax. My dad couldn't have cared less. He's, you know, one of the, he probably is the best person I know. I love him, and he's, you know, one of my heroes. And he just wants me to be happy, like any dad. And no one else was putting pressure, but I was putting immense pressure on myself to try and, I guess, be something I wasn't, or live up to some sort of false expectation. And I think it's a very, very common thing, more common than ever right now with social media, mass media consumption, all of the pressures that, you know, kids are putting on themselves. And it's again, why I am trying to get these messages out there.
Yeah, and when it comes to this, I guess you're the epitome of not judging a book by its cover. I mean, look at you. You're a fantastic-looking guy. You've seemingly had a privileged upbringing. So I guess for people like us, what are some of the signs we can look for in people that may be struggling?
I mean, anything that is out of the norm for a prolonged period of time. So if someone is, you know, withdrawing, having angry outbursts, not sleeping well, showing, you know, prolonged anxiety, socially isolating themselves, really any abnormal behaviours. I mean, sometimes we might have a bad day and have, or, you know, a bad week even, where our behaviour is a little bit off. But if that goes on for a prolonged period of time, normally that is when there's an underlying issue that we need to address. So we need to have the self-awareness to look out for and check in with ourselves and be looking out for these signs in people around us, and, you know, people at work or at school or whatever environment we're in.
You know, the hardest part for many people, and I think especially for men and young boys, is to have the conversation, to actually talk about how you're feeling. We saw yesterday Collingwood player Dane Beams announce that he was taking indefinite leave from the game here in order to deal with his own struggles. Do you think this is the biggest hurdle that people have to overcome?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I think with men, you know, men have traditionally been taught that we need to just push on, that showing emotion means that we're weak, that we're not a man. It's actually the complete opposite. I mean, it takes a lot of courage to show emotion. That's really what, you know, makes you more of a man, if you can just be yourself, be open. I think things like Dane Beams, you know, it's really unfortunate that he's been suffering, but I think that him going out and publicly announcing that is going to help so many people, because this is an AFL star who is struggling. He's human. And we all are, you know. No one is above mental health. You know, I really try and just hammer home how if you're a human, you're going to have physical issues at some point. You're going to have mental health issues at some point. It's absolutely okay. It's part of the human experience. And we just need to understand how to deal with it and how to talk about it, and not, you know, feel shame and all these awful emotions that we have been, on a societal level, made to feel.
Yeah. I could not have put it better. I think you really nailed that absolutely perfectly, Nick. Thank you.